Yo, what's up? We are now sitting in the BMW i3, and today I will tell you a little bit about the problems I found with this car. So, okay, let's start with, this car has active battery cooling. Okay, you knew that. Most people know that, right? Who is in the EV world. But did you know that this car can overheat the battery? Yeah. But I will tell you what happens when it overheats and how you can avoid it, why it actually occurs. So, before I do that, did you also know there's a bug with this car that if you arrive with too low state of charge and you want to charge the car, I forgot to tell you, when you are plugged in and charging it, when you fire up the car, you won't get heat in here. Okay, you might not believe me, but I did the test. I went out and tried with a thermal camera, and initially you will get some heat once you plug it in, but that's just the leftover heat from earlier. But then after just a couple of minutes, you will see that the air vent starts turning blue-ish, and that's because it's not running any heater, and then it's just recirculating some air. I don't know what the heck it's doing. So basically, you don't have any heater while you are plugged in charging, unlike many other EVs. You fire up the car, heater starts, no problem. Okay, and then, but then there is something called auxiliary heater in this car. But auxiliary heater is basically just the heater. Why did BMW call it auxiliary heater? I think it's because they reuse some software from the fossil world, maybe because of the wrecks or something, but it's just the heater. So if you are charging and you activate the auxiliary heater, you will get heat in the car. I also tested that. Once we activated it, after just a couple of minutes, hot air finally came out of the air vents. So even I also tried that even without the auxiliary heater, even if you crank up the temperature to 25, 28 degrees Celsius, it's not gonna help. As long as auxiliary heater is off, there is no heating in the car. And okay, the bug I discovered was that if you arrive with less than 10% and you start charging and you try to activate the auxiliary heater, it will give you an error saying that, because of too low state of charge, we cannot activate the auxiliary heater. Okay, fair enough, but the car should have been so smart that it figures out that we are plugged in at a DC fast charger. Why don't we just allow the car to run the heater? There's no danger here running out of juice anyway. So just as in comparison, in the old days, I just happen to have a Tesla here. My Tesla Model S, when I arrive at the supercharger with 5% left, I plug it in, the supercharger, and then I went inside Yoff's to have some burger, and I wanted to start the heater from remotely. In the old days, you couldn't do that. If the state of charge was below 20%, you couldn't do that. If you're not plugged in, of course. But even if you're plugged in, you couldn't do that. But they fixed it with software update. So now you can arrive with 1% at the supercharger, and then you can start preheating the car because the car is smart enough to figure out that you're plugged in at some high power charger. Okay, enough about that. So the bug again with BMW. If you have too low state of charge, you cannot start auxiliary heater. Okay, fair enough. But if you wait until you have high enough battery and you try to start it again, it still won't work. It's a bug. Because it seems like once you have tried to activate it, then the error message is blocking you. And this car is not smart enough to figure out to try to check every state again before you try to activate it. It should figure out that, okay, we have 40% now, 50%, no problem, we can activate it. No. So what you have to do to avoid that problem is that if you arrive with low state of charge, lower than 10%, and you start charging, wait a couple of minutes until you have more than, let's say 11% something. I'm not sure how it checks it, but at 11, 12%, then you try to activate the auxiliary heater. Then it will work, yeah. Okay, but then back to the problem with the overheating. So what I discovered was that when you run the auxiliary heater, the battery will overheat. And I prepared a little comparison here. So we can watch it. I speeded it up 20 times, I guess. So to the left, we have the car with heater off, right? By default, that will be the one. And then to the right, we have it with the auxiliary heater active. And you will notice that, okay, because the heater is active, it's actually stealing some of the power that would have gone into the battery. So it's charging slightly slower. The car has been designed to maximum take 125 amp. Actually, CCS1 standard allows up to 200 amp, but the car just pulls 125 amp because even if you charge at the high power charger and you have plenty of amps, you have 250, 300 amp available, the car will not pull more than 125 amp. And the problem is that right now you see that we would have gotten 125 plus whatever to the heater, but we can't pull it. That's why it's charging slow. Okay, but anyway, you see now, after charging a while, you actually notice that the battery on to the right starts heating up more than to the left. So I believe that it's overheating. You see, under normal conditions, it's supposed to cool down the battery, but because the auxiliary heater is on, then it's actually overheating the battery. And why is this happening? My only explanation is that this i3 has only one heat pump or one compressor, and it uses that compressor to cool down the battery. But if you activate auxiliary heater, you're stealing that compressor to heat up the cabin. And then the battery is it not cool at all? I believe it's air cool only. Yeah, because if it's not cool at all, then it should overheat way faster, like I've seen in a Leaf. But anyway, okay, I'm talking too much, but do you notice now that the speed has dropped dramatically to the right here? So you see, we're supposed to get almost 50 kilowatt or at least 45 kilowatt, but because the battery is overheating, it's charging way, way slower than expected. So it seems like this battery wants to stay at around 32 to 33 degrees Celsius. Once it goes past a certain threshold, it will start throttling the power. And what can you do actually? Well, I also figure out that. So let's see now. At 90%, I will actually stop the heater and see what happens. So it's charging way slower. I also noticed that you charge way slower than you're supposed to do. So let's wait. There. I switch off the heater now. And what happens now is that it takes a little while because, you know, you have to start cooling down the coolant and all that. And then, but you see that once the heater is off, then the compressor can finally be diverted against cooling down the battery again. And then the battery temperature starts dropping. So, yeah. Let me see. Was it? Yeah, okay. So, what can you do then to avoid this problem? Well, you can avoid running the heater. Is that a good enough explanation, a good enough advice for me? Well, try that when it's minus 10 degrees outside. No, but okay, what you can do is, okay, initially it sounds like a big problem. Like, oh shit, it's like a Leaf, it's rapid gating. No, it's not that big of a problem. So what you can do is you start charging, and then if you're cold, run the auxiliary heater for maybe 5-10 minutes, but then you switch it off again, because even if it's really cold outside, you just running the heater for about 5-10 minutes, it's not gonna do that much damage. And then afterwards, you can allow the battery to cool down again. Or what you could do is that you can avoid staying in the car. If you need to fast charge, go somewhere, have some food or whatever. The car might cool down in winter, or in summer it might heat up a lot, but that's okay, because once you're back after the charging session, you can just quickly heat it up or cool it down. Or what you could also do is maybe start the preheating or pre-cooling towards the end of the charging session, let's say 5 minutes before you arrive, because you can always check in the app, you know. But also, I will show you, so what does this mean then in terms of time lost? Oh, I forgot about this one. Yeah, I made a nice graph. So you see that, as expected, you see that as the temperature rises beyond about 35 degrees, maybe, I think that's, or actually more. No, you see, it's actually, it's charging slower already from the beginning, and that's what I mentioned, you know, it's because the heater is stealing a little bit of power. But you see, at around 45%, then you see a more significant drop, and that's when the temperature goes beyond 35 degrees. So interesting how it works. And then, okay, let's see now. And then what about how much time are you losing in case you, for some reason, has to run the heater on all the time? Okay, I also try to figure out how much you're losing. So, okay, I start, this test just happened to start at 12%. And then I just started calculating at 50% to see, already at 50%, well, it's kind of too early to unplug then, but then you're actually only losing 1 minute, so no big deal. But then if you go to 65%, then you're suddenly losing 3 minutes. And then, but I think many people, they might charge it to 85% because that's when it starts throttling, or maybe even 90%. And then you see that you actually lose 8 to 10 minutes when you charge it higher. And then in percentage, that's actually quite big. So I guess for shorter charging sessions, like I actually did when I did 1,000 kilometer challenge, when I only topped up to 60%, then the overheating doesn't occur right away because the temperature has to go beyond 35 degrees. So in those cases, you can actually just run the accelerator, no problem. Because once you hit 55, 60%, you might be done with the charging session anyway. But then if you need to charge longer, then I recommend you to not run the accelerator. Yeah, so I think that's gonna be it for now. Yeah, well, actually, should I mention it? What? Okay, maybe I should. Okay, I was about to end, but is this a design flaw? Yes, I believe this is a design flaw, and many people don't know about this. And many people will actually deny that, no, it doesn't overheat, but they actually haven't tried it. Just try it the way I did it, and you will find out that your i3 will also overheat. What they should have done was to equip the car with several compressors. One compressor dedicated for cooling down the battery, and another compressor for heating up the cabin. Because I don't know how Tesla works, but the Tesla probably has more advanced system, because actually this summer it was quite hot, or was it last summer? I don't remember. I think it was last summer, yeah, last summer. And people were posting screenshots from a Tesla that they were supercharging. And then there was a message appearing in the screen saying that air conditioning will be slightly reduced, something about that, because it's hot outside. So what does it mean? It means that a Tesla has several compressors that can cool down the battery, but also for cooling down the cabin. But in hot conditions, the car will prioritize cooling down the battery. And then that's what it says in the message, that okay, you might experience a little bit less cooling inside the cabin. So you can't choose. That's just default. Tesla chooses to prioritize cooling down the battery. Whereas this car, it seems like you want heater, okay, they give you heat, but then you overheat the battery. So maybe there should be a way for the car to prioritize cooling down the battery instead, Yeah. So anyway, I think that's gonna be it for now. Hope you guys enjoyed this video. As always, thank you for watching, and talk to you later.